Hi there, thanks for tuning in to Make This Happen, where we discuss an idea we've been dying to see come alive. Every week, my friend Jay Yee and myself, Alex Gonzalez, will bring you a product you never knew you needed. How are you doing today, Jay?
I'm doing pretty good, man. I mean, my nose is a little congested. I don't know what's up with that. I'm
getting allergies through. Or corona? We'll find out in 2 weeks.
Right. I am getting tested on Monday because Adrian is worried because of her workplace. But yeah, that's that.
Oh, that she's bringing home the disease?
Yeah, exactly.
How are you doing? I'm doing all right. Taking my vitamins, losing weight. People say that I started to look skinny. Can you tell?
I mean, yeah, you do look good.
As I fish. Well, that's good. Because you know what I'm talking about this week, non-related? Steroids.
It's kind of related. I mean, steroids can make you look good. Are you taking steroids out?
I'm not using them. No, I'm not. I am not. I am doing at-home workouts, yoga, and running with my dog. But particularly, what I wanted to talk about with steroids is I've always wanted to see. Steroids are pervasive in almost every sport. We know about Lance Armstrong taking steroids, and we know that most bicyclists took steroids for the Tour de France, right?
Right.
Okay. We know that in the UFC and fighting, boxing competitions, people get popped all the time for steroids, right?
Right.
And particularly on top of that, we know that for the biggest competition in the world, the Olympics, teams all across have been popped for steroids. And what we found out through these what we found out across these different competitions is that if it's administered through a doctor, it's actually not particularly harmful and there hasn't been long-lasting effects. It's only if someone self-administers and does the wrong doses. So what I'm proposing here with this whole buildup and rigmarole to get you into this and kind of slide it in, because I understand people would get mad, is I want to propose alternate leaks where there's going to be a regular lead that's completely clean and have the highest tests, and then there's going to be a steroid leak. And this leak is going to be, as long as it's approved by a doctor and you're doing it medically, you can take steroids, you can take human growth hormone, you can take testosterone replacement therapy, you can take what's the other one? EPO, which allows a greater concentration of hemoglobin in your blood in order to deliver you more oxygen. And the reason I believe that is this. I want to see what humans can do. I want to see what happens when you push them to the limits. We already wear glasses, both you and I. I already take protein. I take creatine. I take vitamins. The fact is, and a lot of athletes have put it this way, that if you see a substance on a banned list, like a protein or a particular thing that they sell at GNC, a lot of GNC products actually have steroids because in labs, they don't clean them. So the vats will be reused. You find is that these banned products, people say they're banned because they work. So I would like to see the differences between a steroid league and a regular league, because it wouldn't diminish the natural human league, in my opinion, because if you had someone like Michael Jordan who wasn't taking anything at all and performing at the heights of the steroid league, it would only highlight his athletic ability. So how are we going to make this happen?
I mean, it's not an uncommon thing that people have already suggested, right? So, like, I've heard.
But it's never happened.
Right. And I think, I guess the fear is why would people then watch the regular athlete stuff? And then some athletes might feel pressured to start taking steroids. I understand that, well, like, yeah, it's because it keeps it to the human level, so it's like pushing human ability.
We would have to change the rules slightly in maybe some sports as humans progress. But what would keep them watching the regular sport is the same reason why people watch IndyCar versus NASCAR, right? I mean, the IndyCars go much, much faster. In fact, in all respects, IndyCars are better than NASCAR in every single way. But people still watch NASCAR. Why? Well, it's because the degree of competition is a little bit different and there's nuances placed upon that.
Okay, I have an idea. This is going to be
I won you over?
This is going to be an interesting take. The reason why It kind of sparked from the Indy versus NASCAR thing that you were just talking about. What this is going to end up being probably is we're not doing this here in America.
Let's do it in international waters, like a kumite.
Yeah, we're probably going to do this in like a country like China or something, you know, where they have no problems. You know what I mean? I mean, I'm sure they have some, but...
Well, now we're talking, to be honest, Russia. We know it. It's not the best country in terms of the United States, but we know where they would do it, where they would support it. It's Russia.
And just
Russia
makes
is the land
happy.
Of slap competition. Oh, yes, because they already do.
Yeah, so it's definitely going to it's gonna be something more like
Cuba.
I'm thinking kind of like MMA kind of, where...
Yeah. Oh, Lord. You keep going about MMA because I'll be able to fill in.
All right, so I have to be honest with you guys. I know nothing about sports, so this is a blank spot in my expertise. But I'm going to do the best I can. I'm sorry if I offend anyone with my lack of knowledge in sports, but this is where we're going to go. So MMA, I don't know if this is how it works, but I think it kind of works like the Olympics, where there's like representatives of different countries, right? Or is that UFC?
No, so UFC has fighters that are signed. They're from all over the world.
That's what I'm thinking of. I'm thinking of UFC.
As long as they're allowed to compete. So you'll have fighters from Kazakhstan, Brazil, the United States, Poland. As long as you have the ability, you can be signed.
So I think this is going to be more like that, like UFC or even the esports leagues, where it's like people from all over the world. It doesn't matter if you're American, Chinese, Russian, or whatever. You guys decide to get together, do this sport. We should probably just start with one sport and then be like, you guys are going to be the guys who do the, we're going to put these drugs into you and you're going to be like the best that you could possibly be for whatever sport this is. And they just get the teams together from all over. They do international trading and everything. And, that's the way I see this going, just because it can't be like centralized.
And just to throw in more stuff, just to throw it in and make it even more complex. I even want to do this for esports, because I would really like to see what fighting competitions are like,
on like
StarCraft
Adderall
competitions
and stuff
are.
Like that?
Yeah, because they already do it. Mm-hmm. It's already been told that NFL players take Adderall, that esports people take Adderall. So fuck it. Let them go to town. Let's see what happens. Let's see what kind of crazy plays can happen if they're on a mix of Adderall, Red Bull, maybe a little bit of this, a little bit of that, you know?
Yeah,
afterwards, when the winner wins, they're going to test him, and then they'll publish what he was on, or she. That way, it's public, and then people can get up to that level.
So you think for... Let's just go to the esports side of things. You just think esports, they should just allow it in regular esports? Or do you think they should create a separate league?
There should be two leagues. Exactly. Two separate leagues. Now, this is the thing. At this point, the steroid league is going to be for 25 and older people. And this is where it gets interesting. In esports, it's primarily kids that are under 18. The reason is we lose our reflexes from 18 and up. Our brain cannot respond as fast. But it could probably respond as fast if we were on drugs. And what I mean by drugs is pharmaceutical drugs. Drugs of all names. Doesn't mean that somebody's doing a line and then hitting the Dota. That's not what I'm talking about.
Right.
So all of a sudden, it would make it where you would be able to compete for longer. And also, it would reduce injury. So there would be positive things. Because let's be real. Mike Tyson right now is training at 50 years old. Evander Holyfield is training and over 50 years old. The risk of injury is multiplied by how old you are, not to mention your regenerative recovery skills. But on steroids, not so much, so it becomes safer.
Yeah.
So I'm just saying, if we were to do that, we would actually be able to have an old man league. We could even do stuff where you don't have to hurt each other. I don't want a 65-year-old knocking out another 65-year-old.
Right.
But let's see what happens with swimming. Let's see how fast these guys can get from one wall to the other.
So, where I'm thinking to make this actually happen is we're going to have to start small. So,
and I think we're going to have to do it somewhere where we have to do that back door, like I told you, where we're going to be like, this is safe. Like, we're making it safer for the athletes by making their response times better and their injury rates lower.
And so
what sport could we hit with that?
I mean, it has to be the most popular sport in the world. And there's two of them, depending on what you're thinking of. Soccer, football, of course, is number one all over the world. Second one is baseball, particularly in the Asian countries and here in America, of course.
Could you imagine the amount of Japanese players with their technique with just a little bit of a bump of, you know, the little bit of Mexican yam supplement?
Right.
To get in there, there would be much more Asian players in the American leagues because it's just that they're not built that way.
The thing about those two sports, though, I don't think the athletes being on steroids would be quite as... The difference watching it wouldn't be that big of a difference.
Oh, do you not remember Sammy Sosa versus Mark McGwire in the home run hit-off competition?
But that's like
both
a home run.
Both those guys were loaded to the gills on steroids. Barry Bonds made his name because of steroids.
I guess for baseball, what you would have to do is make the stadiums...
And pitch faster.
You would have to make the stadiums much bigger. You know what I mean?
You can even make the bases a little bit. Now, this is the thing. I don't want it to make it so it's all the way normalized. But, yeah, I would see where you can make the space in between the bases a little bit longer, for sure. That's cool. You can make it so I think the pitcher's mound and the batter's box is fine because the pitcher's going to have a boost, too.
Okay, but what about soccer, though? Because soccer would be the more obvious choice since soccer is...
Well, soccer, we'd have to let it play. I think all of a sudden you're going to see some techniques come out after a couple of years where people are going to be doing massive things, where they're going to be able to jump higher, kick harder from the air, and be able to maneuver and move better so that an older player will be able to juke somebody.
You know what this league would be great for?
What's that?
Blitzball that we created like an episode ago.
Yes, because that's a tough game, especially if you're swimming and hitting.
Yeah,
absolutely.
But how,
the only one I wouldn't want this for, like the one that we'd have to absolutely change, is hockey. If the gorillas get, and I say gorillas in the most respectful way, because hockey players are tough as shit, strong as fuck. But if they got any bigger on that little hockey rink and they're allowed to fight, I'm scared of what will happen. I think pucks will go straight through the face masks.
Another thing that went, so this is just something I'm going to just put out there. Cause when you started talking about this, I thought of one sport in particular that just rang in my mind. Have you ever seen a movie called Starship Troopers?
Very long ago. And I don't really remember movies.
So you're not going to remember the first 30 minutes of that movie,
No.
Where they play like a football rugby fusion sport where they're literally like doing backflips, like Ice Shield 21 style maneuvers where the guy with the ball does a front flip over like the entire lineman line and then goes to the touchdown. You know what I mean? And like,
and that wouldn't be outside the realm of the possibility where a running back could hop over 6 feet, 7 feet. Like, that's something that could occur.
You know, I realized this idea of yours is pretty much you just living out your anime sports, manga sports fantasy.
And there it is. It's exactly what it is. You got it. Right on the dot. I want to see anime sports come to life. And it's almost there with UFC. That's the closest it's ever been, where there's different martial arts styles fighting.
Yeah.
You're absolutely correct. I want to see them go just as far as anime.
Like, you're going to have, like, Prince of Tennis. He's, like, hitting the fucking ball around the net.
And you're going to see it where someone, like, a kid picks up the ball. It's singed on the side that hit the ground.
Well, that happened in real life. People are going to chastise me for not knowing exactly who it was. I think it was Federer. One time, he served the ball, and the ball went into the clay. Just in it. like it just stops and goes in.
See? Now, remember, this is also going to allow, if they're not as physically drained, it's going to allow for their mental capacities to rise too, and they're going to be able to come up with better strategies in the moment, only in the moment. Right. So, where do you think? Soccer, they'll run faster, be more physical.
The last thing I want to add, what if we also, there's another avenue we could also take it is in like a ultimate, what is it called? The Ninja Ultimate.
Oh, Ultimate Ninja Warrior.
That type of thing where it's more like a test of endurance, strength, and just strategy or whatever.
Now, I'm going to go ahead and say this. In terms of steroids, I don't think it should be used in a physical sport until we have enough data. And what I mean is a fighting sport until we have enough data. The reason is I think two 120-pound men who are loaded up to the gills with EPO and TRT are going to hurt each other. However, if it's a 250-pound man swinging his 250-pound body and he has an arm attached to that, it's going to do massive amounts of damage. And although steroids do help you recover, let's go ahead and avoid that. I think what we're going to do is let's target baseball. Steroids have already been in baseball. They've been in baseball a lot. And I don't know enough about soccer.
You, when you're talking about that whole warning thing, a terrifying thought is what if sumo wrestlers did it? These people would be destroying other people. You know what?
And they would also physically look like killing other people. All of a sudden, you would see, well, sumo is about slamming somebody and pushing them out of a ring. So if they fall on there, if they leave from their feet, or if they're out of the ring, they're out. So it would hurt them, but sumo wrestlers typically don't have a lot of injuries.
Well, however, I just mean that first impact would be...
Oh, it would be amazing. The sound.
The sound and the force.
So unique.
There would be a freaking wave of power just coming through that.
By the way, sumo wrestlers would look completely different.
Yeah.
Because the fact of the matter is they're eating 20,000 calories and their bodies can't keep up putting muscle on. However, on this stuff, their bodies would have the capacity to use almost all of those calories to put on muscle. So you would see people that look like Nappa from Dragon Ball Z, sumo wrestling.
Sumo wrestling.
Imagine
crazy,
a bunch of rock people that look like the Dwayne Johnson, but much bigger.
Have you seen sumo in person?
No, I've only watched an anime.
It's insane. It's actually really, really cool.
I respect them for it.
Yeah.
They actually have to live a very disciplined lifestyle.
Real quick before we finish up, I don't know if we're almost done, but just a tidbit for esports. I'm still hung up on that one. We wouldn't be able to make a separate league. I think what it would be more like for esports, since esports is already or still just starting out, you know, this were to come out right now, what I imagine it to be more like is a specific tournament where you're allowed to use. Like Adderall,
and
you know what I mean? Like kind of like the 24-hour or not 24-hour, the speed running community. Like it's just one big event where you go and watch gamers, the best gamers out there, just
and
a little bit more focused.
I think what would be fun about this is we'd have to slowly tiptoe our way into this pool. We wouldn't be able to do a cannonball off the side and just say, we're here, we're juiced, get used to it. No, what we'd have to do is maybe invite a bunch of older professional gamers who haven't been in the spotlight in a minute and maybe give them supplements that would help them. So all of a sudden they're doing, maybe they're on a little bit of Adderall, maybe they're on a little bit of CBD, maybe they're on some Red Bull, and that little concoction gets their anxiety low, makes their brain perform at a higher RPM, and they're able to play. And they're all over 25 and tested that they're healthy and that doctors say that this would be okay.
25
again,
is a good
I'm not trying
age,
to
just because 25 is when you're almost practically sure your body is done.
Yeah, from what I understand from the medical literature, at 25 is when the prefrontal cortex has stopped developing.
Right.
And that's when they suggest that you can smoke weed. That's probably the best time to drink alcohol. It's unfortunate that everything starts at 18.
Right.
In the United States. Actually, maybe 15, 14.
What do you think of in this league that we prepare, it can be co-ed? So both men absolutely. And women.
Not together competing, but I think there should be a women's league that has the exact same rules.
You don't think the steroids will give it a more equal platform, or no?
No, because it's still the way the body works and receptors. I am not a doctor, but we're still improving both of these bodies nominally. So if they're both improved by 50%, it's still a wide gap from men to women.
Gotcha.
Bone density is different. And what would happen? Now, this is the thing. Physical sports, I wouldn't be okay with it.
Right.
If it has anything to do mentally with games, I'd be okay with it. And also certain sports such as running, I'd be okay with it too. And long distance running, I found that women are the top competitors. I think in the Moab, so there's a race where it's about 249 miles continuously. Runners stay up for days to finish it. The top runner was a woman who finished ahead of second place, which was a man, by 8 hours.
Damn.
So it's something like that where physically it's been shown that it can't, like, it's competitive, then I'll let it happen. In fact, if someone brings up that a woman thinks that she can compete and she wants to sign off, okay.
Well, so what I'm getting from you, let's take baseball as the starting sport for this league. I feel like being co-ed could bring some interesting elements to that sport, specifically like if a woman were the batter, sure, she might not be able to hit as far, but she could run much faster. You know what I mean? Or like, being an outfielder, they would be very, very good as well, I feel like.
Now, we haven't tested it, so they could technically play, and it would be up to the organizations to see the statistics and decide whether they would want that player.
Right.
I wouldn't want a woman to be cast out just because she's a woman, but if she can compete and she can run the numbers the same, even though men have certain physical superiorities to women, if somehow the right concoction got her to play at that same level, I'm all for it.
Cool.
So, MLB. No, I guess not. They wouldn't be able to
It would be a completely new acronym, like S.
The Russian Federation for Steroids in Sports. Make this happen. Thanks for listening. If you have any suggestions or products you'd like to see talked about, feel free to write in at atpoundgames@gmail.com. We have a Patreon. If you'd like to join the At Pound family, come find us at patreon.com/wearenotgamedevs. Patrons receive episodes 2 days early, meaning Make This Happen gets to your ears that much sooner. If you enjoyed our show, take a second to give us a review. We're on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Play Store, and more. Catch you guys next Sunday with Jay's new topic, which is
Legend of Zelda. Zelda. I said that funny.
Zelda. We're going with Legend of Zelda. Sounds like you're from somewhere you're not.
Like,
Zelda.
I'm like saying like Hilda with a Z.